In this video, I'm gonna show you how to set up and play Metal Gear Online 2 on PC. You can play this again now thanks to the SaveMGO project. Through a custom server, the game is playable again with PC and PS3 crossplay. This installation is very straightforward, and I'll show you some optimizations you can do as well for performance and the troubleshooting section for any errors that you might encounter. So now, let's begin the tutorial. So the first thing we're gonna do here is create an account on the SaveMGO website. The link will be on the description of the video. And here on the main page, you're gonna come here to the right and click on this login button. It's gonna take you to this page then, and you're gonna click here on register under need a account. So now you just need to fill out the form here by selecting your username, select a password here, and also your email address. But you don't have to confirm this email address, by the way. You just need to remember your username and password so you can use that in game. Then just complete the captcha here and then click on create account. If everything was done right, you're gonna see this screen right here. It's gonna ask you to check your email for the activation code, but like I said, you don't have to do that. This part is optional, but it is a good idea to log into the website because that's how you can access the game shop and transfer the items you buy here into the game. I'm gonna explain more about that later on in the video. Now here on my PC, I have this savemgo.zip file with me, and back on the SaveMGO website, there is this button here that says Windows Setup Guide, and apparently this is a YouTube video, and this YouTube video apparently has a description, but I have no idea what that is about, and I am not going to click here on the Windows Setup Guide. All I know is that I have the SaveMGO file here. So this is a zip file. You're gonna have to extract this with WinRAR or 7-zip or whatever extracting tool you have, right? So right click on it, select your program, and then extract here. This is a big file and it's going to take a little while to extract this depending on how good your CPU is, but just wait until it is finished. When that's done, you can delete the original zip file. We're not gonna need this anymore. So now you're gonna double click on this folder, double click the MGO2 folder, and you're gonna start by double click here on the rpcs3.ex file. This would be a good time to subscribe to the channel and also leave a like on this video. This will open the emulator as such, and you're gonna start by clicking here on the config button. You might get this window here, so go ahead and click on yes. And you don't have to change anything here. These settings are already good to go to play this game online, but you can change a couple of things here, like on the GPU setting. If you want to increase the game's resolution, use the resolution scale option right here to play this at 1080p or even 4K resolution if your PC can support that. In my case, I'm just gonna keep mine at the default resolution. Now here on the IO tab, if you want to use your keyboard to chat in-game, change this from null to basic here. But do know that using the keyboard in this game can cause the game to crash. So if that's happening to you, come back here and change this back to null. Now here on the emulator tab, this is optional. Disable the show PPU compilation hint and the shader compilation hint. These are notifications that the emulator is gonna do every time the game is compiling these shaders, and they can be annoying as well. So I like turning them off here, but that's gonna be up to you. And when you're done, click on apply and then save. Next, you have to configure your controller or keyboard to play the game. And you can do that by clicking here on pads. And this emulator has an automatic mapping function, which means that if you already have your device plugged in, you're gonna come here to handlers and click on X input and just select the device you're currently using. This emulator supports all the main controllers out there from PlayStation and Xbox, and even third-party controllers too, if they have a PlayStation or Xbox controller API. And you can play with a keyboard as well. In my case, I'm using a Xbox controller, so it's X input right here. And just by clicking on here, the emulator will configure the controller for you, but you can change individual buttons as well. You just have to click on them right here and then press the button you want to assign that on your controller. You can also configure the dead zone on your analogs as well. And when you're done, go ahead here and just click on save, and that's pretty much done. Now we can start the game itself, and you can do that by just double clicking here on the Metal Gear Online 2 file. This window will show up, and when you boot it for the first time, it's going to compile these modules and also get some online files as well. This won't take too long, but if you have a really good CPU, then this process will be much faster. After that compilation is done, it is now going to check the game files in here. Now with the game updated, just click on X to close this window and then press X again to start the game. It's gonna look like the game has closed, but it will restart and compile even more modules. Don't worry, because this whole compilation thing only happens when you first start the game. You don't have to go through this every time. Finally, the game will start right here. And if you wanna go full screen, you can do that by double clicking the screen or pressing Alt and Enter on your keyboard. So now press the Start button. You will see the latest information here about the MGO2 project. So go ahead and click on Yes to accept these terms. And now you have to input your username here. So press X once again, and then you're gonna have to type your username and password that you set on the website. On the save option here, you can select to save your username and password so you don't have to input that the next time you start the game. It is this first option here, save your ID and password for the auto login to happen. When you're done, click on OK. After the game is done configuring the port settings, you will see this window here saying that your firewall has blocked some features of the emulator, but go ahead and click on Allow Access right here. Otherwise, you're gonna have trouble connecting to the matches in-game. Now, you have to register your character, of course, give it a name, and then just configure all the settings here from your character creation screen. And finally, you are online on SaveMGO2. So go ahead and click on Lobby Select here, select your desired game mode, the server, there's only one here, and here you can either join or create a game. But if you want to create a game, you have to do a specific setting on your modem, and there is a guide for that on the SaveMGO Discord here. So I'm gonna go ahead and click on Join Game right here. You'll see the list of games currently available. So just click on one of them here, select Join, okay, and the online match will start. If you're having frame rate drops, one way you can increase performance is by disabling the game's shadows. And you can do that by pressing and hold the left and right sticks and the up button on the D-pad for about 3 seconds or so. If you're using a keyboard, you just have to press the respective buttons as well. Take a look at the controller configuration if you don't know what keys they are mapped to. If you don't have sound in-game, that means your CPU does not have the minimal requirements for this game. But there is a few settings you can change here to try to fix that. Back on the emulator, click on Config once again. The first setting you have to experiment here is on the CPU tab, is the Prefer SPU Threads right here. By default, it's set to Auto, and you're gonna change this to number 1, and then you're gonna run the game again and see if the audio is back. But it's not just this setting here, there are more that I'm gonna show you, but what I'm trying to tell you is that you're gonna try with one and the other settings, and you're gonna run the game. If the audio is not back, you're gonna come back here and change this to 2, and then keep increasing this one until the problem goes away. But the other settings you have to change is here on the audio tab. Here on buffering, you're gonna increase the audio buffer duration here. Keep increasing this to like 10 or 20 here, and then run the game again and see if that's back too. Next, right below this setting, you're gonna enable the time stretching here. And on audio out, change from QB to X Audio 2. Now finally, on the advanced tab, on maximum number of sparse threads, by default unlimited, but you have the numbers again. So you're gonna start playing with this setting here too. Start with 0, run the game again. If the audio isn't back, come back here, change to 1, and so on until the problem goes away. But remember, these settings should only be used if you are missing the audio. To unlock and apply the game cosmetics, you have to come back to the SaveMGO website. Make sure you are logged in on your account, and here on the left, you're gonna click here on the reward shop, and you can see all the cosmetics available here. So you can just select the one you want and then click on purchase. You have to use these coins right here that you can get by simply playing the game. And once you buy the cosmetic you want, make sure you're not logged in into the game here, and then just select the character you want to apply and then click on OK. And the next time you boot up the game, the item will be there. If you come across any errors while setting up MGO2, this page here has compiled a bunch of these errors and what you can do to fix them. I'll put the link of this one on the description of the video. And it's also a good idea to join the SaveMGO2 Discord server, not only to get help, but to keep in touch with the latest news about this project and keep in touch with the community. The invite link will be on the description as well. I have many videos like this on the channel covering how to install and play games on PC with the best settings for performance and graphics, so if you like what you saw, don't forget to subscribe, hit the like button, and as always, I'll see you soon.